Hello everyone, my name is Chen Qi and I come from Nanjing Normal University. The topic of my paper is parallel sorted sparse approximate inverse preconditioning algorithm on GPU. I will introduce my paper. The first part is my research motivations. Sparse approximate inverse preconditioners are of great importance on scientific computations because they can efficiently accelerate the convergence rate of Kari-Lau subspace methods for a majority of applications. Due to the high parallelism of static SPAI and its simple operations, many work has been done to accelerate static SPAI preconditioners on GPU. For example, the following pictures are related work done in recent years. In these existing works, He et al. Proposed an effective SPAI preconditioning algorithm on GPU. Figure 1 is the main parallel framework of SPAI adaptive. In this algorithm, an adaptive thread allocation strategy is proposed to assign the optimal thread number for each column of the preconditioner. Each column is computed using k-threads on GPU, and as shown in Figure 2, the k is allocated according to the maximum number of non-zero entries in each column of preconditioners. But this method has obvious drawbacks. Its adaptability is effective only when the number of non-zero entries in each column of the preconditioner is the same or the difference among them is small. Otherwise, it may be worse than the one that uses a constant web number. Inspired by these observations, we further invested how to parallelize the static SPAI preconditioner highly on GPU and present a new thread adaptive allocation strategy. On the basis of the proposed strategy, we present a new SPAI algorithm on GPU called GSPAI adaptive. Next, I will show the parallel framework of GSPAI adaptive, and is shown in Figure 3. It includes the following three stages. First, in pre-GSPAI stage, we define the sparsity of M, compute the dimensions, and assign the thread number adaptively to each column of M. In this part, a new thread allocation strategy is proposed, which includes the following steps. First, we sorted the number of non-zero entries of mk values in descending order and use the SC array to map the name column indices. Then, for each n2k, the number of threads zk is computed by the following formulas. And then, zk threads are grouped into a thread group, which is assigned to compute the kth column of M. Meanwhile, if the thread group size is obtained by formulas mentioned above, the size of thread groups it will be likely different inside a block. But this situation will decrease the performance and be difficult to implement on GPU. Thus, we fine-tune the thread group size of computing each column of M, so that the thread group size in each block is the same and may be different among blocks. Then, we use a matrix as an example to illustrate this strategy. Assuming that M has 14 rows and 14 columns, the number of non-zero items of 14 columns is shown in the array n2k, and we set nt equals 32. Based on the formula 1 and 2, the number of threads assigned to 14 columns is shown in the second line. Then, we fine-tune the thread group size and store it in the array ws. Finally, we obtained that we need 3 blocks with thread group size for 16, 8, and 4 to calculate the columns of M. The second part is compute GSPAI stage. We transfer necessary values to global memory. In this part, we first find the array G for each block, letting each thread group to compute one of subsets of G assigned to the block, and the threads find the indices satisfying formula 3. According to G, each block computes subsets of I assigned to the block in parallel. Then, using I and G, the local submatrix is constructed by loading columns indexed in G key and match them to I key in parallel. Then, we decompose the local submatrix into Q and R using modified Gram-Schmidt method. Based on Q and R, the value of M tilde K are computed according to the following formula. In the final stage post-GSPAI, we assemble M in the compressed sparse column storage format and store it to MPTR, MIndex, and MDate arrays. First, we restore M to the original indices using the SC array, and then use the JPTR array to assemble MPTR, and utilize MPTR and SC arrays to assemble MDate and MIndex. Finally, we evaluate the performance of GSPAI Adaptive using NVIDIA GTX 1070 and Titan XP GPUs in order to prove the validity of GSPAI Adaptive. From Table 1, we can observe that without preconditioner, for some matrices, GPU by conjugate gradient stabilized method cannot converge in 10,000 iterations, while GPU preconditioned by conjugate gradient stabilized method can converge under 1,226 iterations. Meanwhile, for other matrices that GPU by conjugate gradient stabilized methods can converge, the number of iterations and execution time decline dramatically using the preconditioner. Second, we take GTX 1070 to investigate the effect of increasing TOR on the execution time of GSPAI Adaptive and the GPU preconditioned by conjugate gradient stabilized method. The experimental results are shown in Table 2. And first, as the TOR increases, it in general decreases, although the execution time of GSPAI Adaptive increases. Then, beyond a certain threshold, the increase of TOR can have a reverse effect on it. In all our test cases, a large TOR is almost well chosen. Finally, we test the GSPAI Adaptive performance by comparing it with CSR ILU0 IncuSparse and the static approximate inverse preconditioning algorithm in Vienna CL and the latest sparse approximate inverse preconditioning algorithm. Table 3 and Table 4 show the comparison on two GPUs. We can see in Table 3, the total time of GSPAI Adaptive and GPU preconditioned by conjugate gradient stabilized is the smallest among all algorithms for all matrices except for the last matrix. Meanwhile, we can get the same conclusion from Table 4. This result indicates that GSPAI Adaptive is advantageous over others and significantly improves the performance of SPAI Adaptive. Thank you for your attention. My report is over.